What's up, everybody? Despite the cold temperatures, we did have high school football round four football games tonight here in East Texas. The big one, the rematch between Kilgore and Chapel Hill. To Rose Stadium we go. The winner moves on to the state semifinals in Class 3A Division 1. Early on, it's all defense for Kilgore. What a play right here as Stephon Tatum intercepts Andrew Black, and that would set the tone as Juju Brown takes it in for the touchdown. Good bit of running right there, 7-0 Kilgore. And then the fast Kilgore running back, that is Kevin Justice, gets hot, gets out loose here, takes it to the house, touchdown Kilgore, 14-0 just like that. Andrew Black finally gets going here, hits his man Gabriel Robinson, that's a first down. And then Wesley Thompson off the read option, he busted through for the touchdown. PAT no good. 14-6, so Chapel Hill's on the board. But here come that ground game for the Red Dogs. Cameron Justice again for a touchdown. That would make it 21-6. Another touchdown by Juju Brown here. 31-6 at half, and it is a rout, folks. Ring that victory bell. Final score in this one is 59-19. There it is. Kilgore, easy win tonight as they move on to the semifinals where they'll take on the Stephenville Lubbock Cooper winner. Now, with more on this big win by the Red Dogs, let's go live out to Trinity Mother Francis Rose Stadium. Our Jeff Schaefer was freezing all game long. He joins us now from the stadium. And, hey, another impressive victory, Jeff, by the Kilgore Bulldogs. Can anybody stop them?
Eric, it sure doesn't look like anybody can stop Kilgore right now. I mean, you just saw in the highlights, they essentially ran all over Chapel Hill tonight. And that duo of Kevin Justice and Juju Brown, I mean, that it's a deadly combination. And, I mean, they aren't even the only guys who can run. I mean, Benny Colbert, the quarterback, can get things done. I mean, Kilgore just has so many weapons, and they showed it tonight. And they also show their defense. I mean, the defense has been great all season long as well. And that early interception, I think it didn't end the game early, but it almost, you know, stop Chapel Hill before they even got started. And I mean, Kilgore's just been dominant, and you know, now moving on to the state semis again. They were there last year, and they've even got some extra time to prepare for that, because the Stephenville and Lubbock Cooper game, that's not gonna be played for a couple days. So another advantage for the Bulldogs, and I mean, they just look dominant here tonight at Rose Stadium, Eric.
And Garrett, the folk talk, get warm. Great job. 59-19, Kilgore victorious. All right, let's go back. We'll go back to Class A, 3A in a moment. Right now, we've got to check in on the White Oak Roughnecks and what a run they have been on. Best season since 1970, taking on Franklin down in Palestine. Here we go. Cheeto Chukwa is going to drop back the pass for Franklin, and what a play here by that Roughneck defense. Jake Pullen, right place, right time, gets the pick. He almost takes it all the way, just out of the reach of the hands there, and that would set up what Dylan Gale and this offense has been doing so well of late. Riley Laking doing what he does. Another masterful game by White Oaks rushing attack. They take the early 7-0 lead, and then Franklin just didn't have it tonight. They were undefeated coming in. They're dropping the football left and right. Did not like the cold weather, but Josh Benson sure did. He recovers it for the Roughnecks. That would lead to this field goal by Jack Rogers, and field goals on a night like tonight, impressive. How about this? White Oak, 31-0. They are moving on to the state semifinals. Way to go, Coach Stafford and the Roughnecks over in Carthage tonight. Here we go. The Bulldogs taking on in Carthage, Wascom taking on Corrigan Camden. And early on in this one, Hayden Armstrong up for grabs. Junebug Johnson. Have we been calling this guy's name all playoff run long or what? What a play by Junebug. But Corrigan Camden would get on the board and take the lead as Addison Kirkland, oh, looking like a man among boys right here, dragging Wascom into the end zone. That would make it 8-3 after the two-point conversion. But play of the night's got to go to this young man right here. Trace Carter just pitches it to Kevin Johnson. He goes left. He says, hey, I'm going to take a right turn here. I'm going to go back left. I'm going to juke and jive all the way to the house for the touchdown. And Wascom, the dream is still alive. They take care of Corrigan Camden. 24-22 is your final score. Now we go back to Class 3A. The Carthage Bulldogs, they've been rolling all postseason long. Tonight back in Beaumont to take on a very good West Orange Stark team. Opening drive, though, the Bulldogs just show everybody who's boss as Blake Blogan shoots so good this year. Rifles this one to O'Carrion Rutherford. That would move the chains. And then Tevin Pipkin, he's the ground attack for the Bulldogs. Takes it from Blogan, shoots, and up the gut he goes. 20-yard touchdown, 7-0. Now, this will turn out to be a very close ball game, but Carthage holds on. They are moving on to the regional finals, or excuse me, state semifinals. 28-14 is your final score. Next stop is to Waco. Fairfield, perfect so far, taking on Rockdale tonight. After a great start for Fairfield, Jacob Gallegos gets intercepted by LaDonta's coach right here, but Gallegos gets it back going. Great pass over the middle to Alex Ward, and then he would hook up with Larry Rose right here on the little bubble screen. He would take it to the house, and Fairfield is rolling, folks. Touchdown right there. 42-7 is your final score. Congratulations to Fairfield. 10-all. Also a winner tonight as well. 24-7. They take care of Bremen. Great night for East Texas. And don't forget, we got a Saturday game tomorrow. We got a Dangerfield in New Boston over Mount Pleasant at 2 o'clock. Justin, Gladewater Argyle won't play until Monday because of all the bad weather. And, of course, etfinalscore.com. Watch all the highlights, all the matchups for round number 5 as well. Woo! What a night.
Wide open. Wow.
I'm telling
you. Something else.
We'll be back over there this week to see him.
We'll be right back.